Namaskar, I am Dr. K K Aggarwal, President, Heart Care Foundation of India and Group Editor-in-Chief, Med Talks. The question I am going to answer today is, who am I? Am I the wave? What is the genesis of mantra? The answer is yes. We are nothing but waves. We are made out of nothing. From nothing, waves arises. Waves gets converted into quantum of energy, which is bundles of waves, and they converted them into a matter. Therefore, when I talk about a unmanifest or the manifest, at the level of unmanifest, at the level of non-matter, I'm nothing but waves. These waves in my body are being classified in form of five tanmatras. So let's give an example that I have a silent state of awareness where there is no wave, not even a non-moving wave. I am just a potential and just a possibilities called so-called God. And in that field of infinite possibilities, because of a desire, a wave starts. So therefore, everything is when there is a unmanifest converting into manifest, there has to be a desire. When that desire comes, when the evolution of the human being came, the first desire was in the form of a shabd, in the form of a bij mantra. And these shabd basically belong to the vowels and nasik vyanjans, nasal consonants. A, E, I, O, U. Therefore, all bij mantra will have sounds of the nature. They will be A, I, U, A, O. And then came the sound called nasik vyanjan, which is nasal consonants, the last word of each Hindi aksharmala, ma, na, ga, na, na. Therefore, a combination of a vowel and a combination of a nasik vyanjan or a nasal consonant became the bij mantra of every religion. Om in Hinduism, then we have Hung in Buddhism, then in Islam and Christianity we have Amin and Amin. So everywhere the sounds Ikonkar, and then we came with Onkar mantra in Namokar mantra in Jainism. So everywhere it was a combination of a swar and a vyanjan. These are the bija sounds. Now these bij sounds which came from the nature, then there came the consonants. They formed five types of tanmatras. First was shabd. From shabd came sparsh. From sparsh came roop, then ras, and then gandh. So these waves form five different types of tanmatras. That is shabd, sparsh, roop, ras, and gandh. So these five different types of forms, they created a hard disk of these five different hard disks. So every experience of my body will become a tanmatra or a qualia. It will become a shabd qualia, sparsh qualia, roop qualia, ras qualia, or a gandh qualia. Therefore, every experience, every hormone, every matter in my body ultimately is a non-matter in the form of a qualia, and the root cause of that qualia is shabd. Because from shabd came sparsh, from sparsh came roop, from roop came ras, from ras came gandh. So therefore, I am nothing but a silent state of awareness. From where arises the waves, the origin of the waves is in the form of a sound. Therefore, healing is possible, mantra therapies are possible scientifically, though we may not have an answer in our modern system of medicine. We not have a gadget to them, but we know that whenever we are in pain, the sound which comes is ah, ih, ooh, eh, ouch. These are vowel sounds, and we know vowel chanting produces interleukin too. And we also know whenever we are disturbed, we chant a nasik vyanjan. We say we chant na or ga. We know these are the sounds when we weep, and we know they produce delta activity in the EEG. Therefore, Om is both a physical and a mental healer. It produces interleukin too, and it produces delta activity in the EEG in the form of a tranquilizer. Therefore, all bij mantra, when they combine together a vowel and a nasik vyanjan at the level of our basic body, produces healing. Therefore, every sound, every consonant, the sound la, lam, is for attachment. Vam. So therefore, the bija sounds like lam is to take away the fear, vam is to take away the attachments, ram is to take away the doubt, yam is to increase our loving characteristics, yam is for truthfulness, and om is for non-judgmental. That means every sound somewhere is linked with an emotion. You can heal that, you can use that. So if somebody asks you, is there a genesis of mantra? The answer is yes, because we are nothing but waves. In a silent theater of awareness, which is our consciousness, because of a desire to produce something, a wave is generated, and that wave leads ultimately to the action, and there becomes a triad of action, memory and desire. And if that desire is not fulfilled, that leads to kaam, krodh, lobh, moh, ahankar. So therefore, basic thing is, learn to relax, go into a silent state of awareness. And if you want to go into a silent state of awareness, you will need to use a Bija Mantra. Thank you.